Okay, this theorem 3.42, also known as squeeze theorem, okay, what it tells us is that there is a Boolean sequence bounded below by An and bounded above by Cn. Both An and Cn are going to the same limit L. Okay, what happens here is because Bn is trapped between these two, from below An push Bn towards L, and from top also Cn push Bn towards L. So it gets squeezed and trapped between An and Bn, get dragged into limit L. Okay, so this why we call it squeeze theorem, because it gets squeezed from top and below from An and from above Cn. Okay, so in the proof, we will first write the definitions of this limit An equal L. Now that means for any given epsilon, there is some N1. If N is greater than N1, this term is less than epsilon. No? And then I can drop the absolute sign by using the definition, and then I move L. Okay, you will see why in a minute. So I arrive at 3.73. Now, if I look at the Cn going to L, okay, there is another N2. These two N's are different. That's why we label it with N1 and N2. No? And N bigger than N2, Cn minus L satisfy this condition. And again, using the absolute value sign and moving L, I arrive at 3.76. Now I want to make both of these statements true simultaneously. You know the drill, no? We take N to be maximum of N1 and N2. Now if N is bigger than N, it is bigger than N1 and also N2. So it satisfies 3.76 and 3.73. No? Now what I need to is the Bn to satisfy those. So Bn is in the middle. An is a lower bound, L minus epsilon is a lower bound for An, so because of that from I get L minus epsilon is a lower bound for Bn. Same way, this Bn is bounded below by Cn and Cn is bounded above by this epsilon plus L, no? So because of that Bn is bounded above by L plus epsilon. So then I move L, and using the definition of absolute sign again I can arrive here. Now I have the required statement. Now for any given epsilon there is N, so that when N is bigger than N, Bn satisfies this condition. That means limit of Bn is L.